Hi, my name's Mario. Are you between the ages of 18 and 37? Do you experience anxiety? Do you experience anxiety more than once a week? If so, I want to tell you about a brand new... I'm kidding. This is not a commercial for Prozac or for Zoloft or anything like that. But I tell you what, I do want to talk about that. I want to talk about something that I don't think we talk about enough, but we all experience it. And I'm talking about anxiety. Roll the clip. Anxiety, it's a real thing. The American Psychological Association defines anxiety as an emotion characterized by feelings of tension, worried thoughts, and physical changes like increased blood pressure. I don't know how you got to this video, but I do want to let you know of one thing, that a lot of us, whether we want to admit it or not, do experience anxiety from time to time. I think it's very natural for us as humans. But the Bible says something very different about anxiety, but I'm not going to address that quite yet. I want to tell you the story of how I had this anxiety attack, but more importantly, how I got out of it. I was sitting at work and, you know, nod your head if any of these things sound familiar to you. Now, I'm very much aware that there are extreme cases, but this is the one I had. I was sitting there and it sounded like 1,000 people were talking to me, but it was dead silent around me. It sounded like there were people all around me in my bubble, per se, but I was just surrounded by four walls. It felt like I wanted to focus. I really wanted to focus on one task at a time, but 1,000 other tasks came out of nowhere. And I felt like I was having a conversation with myself and 30 other versions of myself. It was awful. And the hardest thing about it was I couldn't just escape, couldn't just leave work. I had to deal with it. And so I thought maybe stepping outside would solve it, but it didn't. I thought that maybe a little silent prayer would solve it, but it really didn't. It wasn't until I finally stepped away and went on a drive and really just poured out my heart in prayer and just really asked for God to free me from this. I realized what I was going through and I needed an answer. I desperately needed a savior, and so I just called out to Jesus. Jesus, bring peace to my mind. I don't know what's conflicting me right now. And I tell you what, in retrospect, I felt completely different from before the genuine prayer and then after the genuine prayer. It was amazing how fast Jesus worked. The Bible doesn't talk about anxiety. As a matter of fact, it tells us we're not supposed to experience this because God's given us a different type of spirit. When Paul writes to Timothy in 2 Timothy 1:7, he tells us that for God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. Now, you know what's so funny about that last part, a sound mind? We can define the word sound as the translation of slaves through our ears and how our mind interprets it. But in this specific passage, Paul's not describing a mind full of sound. He's describing a sound mind as a mind that is thinking rationally and logically. Or as one Bible commentator said, he has given you a mind that has been delivered, rescued, revived, salvaged, protected, and brought into a place of safety and security so that it is no longer afflicted by illogical, unfounded, and absurd thoughts. Wow, that's the type of mind we're supposed to have? So why in the world was I experiencing this? After the anxiety went away, I really started thinking on this and I went to the Word and I'm convinced that anxiety is one of two things. Now, before I share this thought, I don't have any biblical evidence. I don't have any biblical proof on it, but just hear me out. One, the first way I think of what anxiety is, I think it's a direct attack from the devil to distract you from doing the things that God wants you to do. Now, does that sound kind of familiar? If you can't breathe, if your chest tenses up, if you've got 1,000 conversations going, if you feel like everyone's around you, if you feel like there's all this noise in your head, how in the world can you focus? How in the world can you focus on the thing that God wants you to do? That's the first way I think of what anxiety might be. But then I really started thinking about it, and I think I may have found the answer. A Again, before I say this, this is just my own opinion, but according to Galatians 5:17, let's see what the Bible has to say on what might be happening in our mind. For the flesh lusts against the spirit, and the spirit against the flesh. And these are contrary the one to the other, so that ye cannot do the things that ye would. Imagine this. Your mind is the battleground, is the place that controls your body. And for me, I've got God's spirit who inhabits my body, but I also have my flesh. And the flesh wants to do a certain thing, and the spirit wants to do a certain thing. And what I believe might be happening during these moments of anxiety is your soul is in conflict with your flesh. And so the mind becomes a battleground for what the spirit wants for you to do, and then what the flesh wants for you to do. Just like it says in Galatians 5:17, that these are contrary to one another, that these are not in agreement. So is it so absurd to think that an anxiety attack could be a battle between your spirit and your flesh on what your spirit knows you need to be doing on versus what your flesh wants you to do? Man, I don't know if that's what anxiety is, but I tell you what, I'm convinced that that makes sense, that my spirit was trying to take over my mind and get things done, but my flesh was also trying to make up my mind and get things done on its own agenda. Again, it could be many, many things, but let's get one thing straight. We're not supposed to have anxiety, because remember, for God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power, it's a strong word, but of love, that's also a strong word, and of a sound mind. Why would a sound mind in that verse be any less than what power and what love means? I think we're supposed to be rationally, logically thinking to get things done for God's kingdom. I don't think for one second that Jesus, if he really wanted to accomplish through us, would not want us to think correctly. He would want us to think correctly so he can do the things that he needs to do through you and I. So next time that you're in that moment of anxiety, wherever you are, call out to God. If you're at work, I don't care. Run to the bathroom, because if you want to experience that, that's on you. But if you know there's a way out of it by calling on the name of Jesus, why wouldn't you take that option? Now, I know this video is a little bit random, but I tell you what, anxiety, this is something we need to take head on as apostolics. We need to call out on the name of Jesus. And he will free us, and he will give us that liberty that we so desperately desire. Thank you all for watching. My name is Brother Mario.